Hey guys, what's going on? You guys seem to enjoy my last tier list video where I ranked every single mob in Minecraft Dungeons. So today we're going to be ranking every single boss in Minecraft Dungeons. If you find yourself enjoying this video, be sure to subscribe. It helps me out a lot and I appreciate it. But anyways, in this video, we are going to start with the four mini bosses, I guess you could call them. The first one is the Evoker. These four aren't actual, like, end-of-the-level bosses, except maybe the Evoker, because in Pumpkin Pastures, you fight one of these at the end after you clear a couple waves of mobs. So I guess he could be considered, like, a normal boss. But I don't personally consider him a main boss, because you can fight him at random times in different levels as well. But anyways, he's pretty straightforward. As long as you have Radiance, you'll do fine. And honestly, if you have Radiance, you'll do fine against pretty much any of these bosses, with a few exceptions. It's one ground attack is the only kind of scary thing. The mobs that it spawns in aren't that good, and you can pretty much one-shot them. So I think I'm going to put him in D. I don't think any of these bosses are really going to fall in E or F, because they all have certain things about them that are pretty good. Except maybe for our next one, which is the Enderman. The Enderman is so simple to deal with. You just straight attack and there's not really much to it. He just teleports away after you attack him a certain amount and then he'll come back from a different angle. But that's pretty much all there is to the Enderman, so he actually might go into E for now at least. The next boss we're going to be talking about is the Redstone Golem. Out of the four mini bosses, he is probably the hardest out of the four just because he's so tanky and he can set down explosive mines all around him that if you run into they will damage you a lot. And he also slams the ground a lot. But like I said earlier, if you have Radiance, he's pretty easy to deal with. So we'll probably put him in the C category for now. And now the final mini boss one is the Skeleton Horseman. They spawn in, I think, groups of three. And they can do a decent amount of damage, but they're really weak. So they're not like too much to be worried about. So we're going to put them in D with the Evoker. Now going on to all the main bosses. The first main boss that you'll run into is the Cauldron. Even though this is one of the first bosses you'll run into, I personally think he's one of the more difficult ones, especially when you don't have as good gear, like when you're running through this game, your first run through on story mode rather than adventure or apocalypse mode. The reason he can be so annoying is because he spawns so many pink slimes that can shoot at you, and the quickest way to deal damage to him is to melee him, but he also has fire that goes around him every now and then and it burns you up really quick, so that's really annoying. So you got to switch between meleeing and bowing this one. So we're actually probably going to put him in A tier, believe it or not. Many of you guys may disagree with that move, but I think he's one of the more annoying bosses to deal with. The next boss we're going to talk about is the Nameless One. This is on the Desert Temple level. I don't think I mentioned it before, but the Cauldron was on the Soggy Swamp. But this one's on Desert Temple. This one can be a little annoying to deal with unless you have the shield totems. Those make this boss, along with one of the later bosses, a lot easier to deal with. As long as you can dodge his green bullets and take out the skeleton vanguards or whatever they're called around, that he spawns in pretty easily, you'll do fine with this one. I think I'm actually going to put this one in A as well, just because it can be annoying if you don't have the shield totems. Next up, we have the Redstone Monstrosity. This one is probably B tier, personally. The only annoying thing about this is the magma cubes that it spawns in. If you let all of them like group up and go on you, they can be really annoying to get rid of, but they're pretty weak. And another thing I find interesting about this one is there's four like explosive things that you can press, but you have to, when you press them, they can damage him, but you got to make sure you get out of the way or else they will pretty much one shot you. But other than that, he works pretty much like the Redstone Golem, so we're probably gonna put him in B tier, because he is not as difficult as the last two to deal with. Now, the Arch Illager, which is the first section of the final boss before you fight the Heart of Ender. He is probably the easiest out of all the main bosses, just because he doesn't have that many moves and he's pretty weak. And his moves, if they do hit you, they don't do a ton of damage. He just spawns in mobs and shoots flame balls at you pretty much. And he's really easy to deal with, so we're gonna put him in the C category. Now we're down to the final two. This one is the Heart of Ender. If you have the Totem of Shielding, like I said, you should use with the Nameless one. He is pretty easy, but his lasers that he shoots are really annoying, and his fire, I think, can go through shields now when he throws the fire down. So he's gonna be in S tier because he's one of the more difficult bosses, especially your first time through the game. I had the most trouble with this boss out of any other boss when I was first going through on story mode. Obviously, when I got through to like apocalypse mode, I was a lot more geared up and knew what to expect, so he was a lot easier then. But he's still quite a beast to deal with. And the final one we have to deal with is the Mushroom Monstrosity. This is very similar to the Redstone Golem and Redstone Monstrosity, but it spawns in mushroom cows, and it can shoot rocket like mushrooms at you that explode and do a ton of damage. So this one's really annoying to deal with. I'm actually probably going to put it up in S tier because it's so tanky, and when it does shoot stuff at you, it does get kind of annoying if you don't have shields with you. This is my tier list for all of the bosses in Minecraft Dungeons so far. I might make an update video when DLC comes out, because I'm sure they will be adding more mobs and more bosses in the future. I think I kind of nailed this one. There's not too many bosses to put down, but I think I put them all in fair spots. Let me know if you think anything belongs in spots that I didn't put them at. And make sure you go check out the video where I rank every single mob in Minecraft Dungeons if you haven't already. And that's going to be it for this video. If you enjoyed, make sure to leave a like and subscribe for more. And I'll see you guys in the next video. So loud, he opens his mouth.